Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick. This is actually my third video, but I'm going to probably load this one first because I think it's going to be the shortest. I have a word from the Lord. I was on, which I usually don't have time to go on Facebook, but the Lord really led me to go on there. I mean, I go on there and do the Joshua's Ministry group. The link is under here if you want to see the pictures of the orphanage and the feeding programs, all we're doing here. You can go join the Joshua's Ministry group on Facebook. The link is here and see what we're doing, some of the things we're doing here. Anyway, I went and I was looking at what people was posting, and which I normally never have time to do. Someone had posted about how in with the Russian occupied area of Ukraine, they're dropping flyers on the people saying, if you're a Jew, you need to register with us. You need to register with us, register all your property and all this stuff, or you'll be deported and all this. So of course, they're registering the people's property now because they're going to do what the Nazis did. They're going to take it from them. And what the Lord spoke to me is, the motto is of Israel is never again. Never again. So I said, well, the motto to myself, self, the motto of Israel is never again, so maybe Israel will strike and attack Ukraine. And then the Lord said to me, said, Patrick, stop talking to yourself and listen to me. No, the Lord said to me, he said, you know, there's the battle of war of Gog and Magog, Ezekiel 38 and 39. That is going to be now, soon. And I do believe it's pre-trib, even though it doesn't have to be. I believe it's pre-trib because there's a set, it takes 7 years to clean up the mess. That's different because, there, you know, one person had tried to debate that with me when I mentioned this before. There is another Gog and Magog uprising of the children of the tribulation saints at the end of the millennial reign of Christ. That's different. Go read the text. You'll see there are two different things. This one in Ezekiel 38 and 39 happens not in the millennial reign, but in this church age, in the age before the return of Christ. It's very clearly stated in the text. As you read it, you'll see it's not the millennial reign of Christ. When the war of Gog and Magog from Ezekiel 38 and 39 happens. It's a shame I have to say those things because there's always one person, you know, maybe they watch videos on YouTube about brain surgery and then they show up at the operating suite in the hospital and try to jump in front of the doctor and start doing brain surgery. Maybe they watch a video about, you know, about law. Maybe they watch Law and Order, then they go to the courthouse and try to correct the judge. I don't know, but there's always one, and it's sad. Let's pray for them that they will have humility, because arrogance is a huge problem among people on YouTube. Maybe it's the anonymity of hiding behind their computer that they feel that they can, you know, be belligerent and arrogant and prideful, where maybe in real life they're not that way. Anyway, brothers and sisters, the word that the Lord gave me, I'm sorry about that, but as the Spirit would lead me, I'll speak. And I have no apologies to speak the Lord's word, only apologizing that I didn't get to the point. Anyway, brothers and sisters, the word that the Lord gave me, he said, Patrick, this, you know, about the, he quickened in my spirit about the war of Gog and Magog. And the Lord said this, it's the word of the Lord for the world, the non-believers. The Lord says, I will shake the nations, which we've already been having lots of earthquakes. I'll shake the nations because they've touched the apple of my eye. They threaten to touch the apple of my eye. I will shake the nations. And I'll tell you what, the Lord is referring to the battle of Gog and Magog. Now, right now, brothers and sisters, all over the world, we're having all kinds of earthquakes. You don't believe that, go look at raptureready.com or any of these. There's dozens of earthquakes happening, all various, diverse places all over the world, as King James says, in diverse places. Matthew chapter 24, I believe, is verse 6 or verse 7. There'll be wars and rumors of wars and, you know, and earthquake, famines and pestilence and earthquakes in diverse places or various places for those of you who are King James illiterate. All over the place. And we've been having those. But the Lord's about to shake the nations. And I mean, he's going to shake them. The wars and rumors of wars have been nothing. They've been nothing. The earthquakes we've seen have been nothing. The Lord is about to descend from heaven with a shout, as the Lord is leading me, with the voice of the archangel and the trumpet of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first, and those of us who are alive and remain shall be caught up with them to meet the Lord in there. So shall we forever be with the Lord, for the Lord is preparing a place for us that we shall forever be with him. That's John chapter 14 and 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 16 through 18. Therefore, wherefore, comfort one another with these words. But for you who are in the world, who are lost and without hope and as strangers and enemies of the covenants of God, the wrath of God abides on you. John chapter 3. And the wrath of God is being released into this world even as we speak. Even as the work of the devil, the darkness and gross darkness is rising on the earth. There's some people who reject the word of God in the rapture and say, you know, it's the devil's wrath. Guess what? The devil's wrath is the judgment of God. Don't you know that he that now letteth will let until he's taken out of the way? And that another, for you King James, illiterate, letteth means to restrain. He is the restrainer. That's why we call him the restrainer. You think an angel can restrain evil? No. For those of you who are self-appointed theologians, the Archangel Michael is an angel, but he's not God. Only God, the Holy Spirit, can restrain and hold back the force of evil. Just the force of evil is held back by the force of good, what we call good. What the world calls good, the force of light, the force of love, the force of joy, unspeakable and full of glory. That's the Holy Spirit. See, what the problem is with people that are not Christians and not Spirit-filled Christians, what you don't know is you've already been walking in the light. What you see on earth now is already filled with the light of God, but you can't see it. It's like if you went into a restaurant and they had candlelight and you sit in that restaurant for hours and someone were to turn on the lights, you'd say, wow, I didn't realize how dim it was in here. That's for us when you get saved, when you get filled with the Holy Spirit. It's even a whole nother level of light. But for those of you who are in the world today, this is a message for you who are not saved and not truly born again. I'm not talking about mental assent, as they call it, just in your mind you agree with the gospel. Those who are truly born again, the light that you have now, you don't know you have, it's about to go out. Because the Bible says that the spirit of a man is a candle of the Lord. The Lord has just given that as a witness that the Holy Spirit through the church will be removed. He who now lets, 2 Thessalonians chapter 2, the restrainer will be removed. The light of God through the spirit of his church. And the lights are about to go out. This world is about to experience the biggest blackout. Don't worry, and there's people thinking cardinal-minded, don't worry about electricity. Don't worry about that. Don't worry about an EMP bomb. Don't worry about an electromagnetic pulse bomb. That's the least of your worries. You better worry about where your next meal is coming from. You'll say this as God told Israel, if they would reject him. When it's day, you would say, I wish to God it was night. And when it's night, you say, I wish to God it was day. There is no rest and no peace for those who reject the Lord Jesus Christ. And that day of the year of Jubilee is coming to an end. The age of grace, where you've been walking in light when you didn't earn any light. You didn't deserve any light. Even though you're a stranger of the commonwealth of Israel, and you're enemies of God, lost and without hope in this world, Ephesians tells us. I believe it's Ephesians chapter 2. You're lost and without hope in this world. Enemies of God. You don't know it because the light of the Lord is shining through the Gentile church. It's about to be removed. There will be sudden darkness to hit this land. And the only light that will be seen is when God raises up that standard. As the enemy would come in like a flood, the standard of the 144,000 witnesses will be raised up. And then the two witnesses, the two prophets of God will be raised up there in Jerusalem for Israel. And then the 144,000 will go to the world, bringing in the harvest, focusing on to the Jew first and then to the Gentile. Praise God. I pray that you'll be able to make it through that long night. Hitler had his night of the long knives, Kristallnacht, there in 1938. The Gentiles are about to have their Kristallnacht as the demons, the brown shirt demons, come to wreak havoc on the Gentile world. Everything that Hitler did to the Jewish people, the demons of Satan, the wrath of Satan, that the people think is the wrath of Satan, which actually is God has taken his Satan off of a leash. As we say, he is our controlled opposition. And God is about to cast him down to earth and cut him loose. As it says, Michael and his angels will cast Satan and his angels down to earth. And he knows his time is short, because his wrath is fierce, because he knows his time is short. God is about to unleash his pit bull, the devil, on this earth. Get that through your head and get that in your heart, that God himself will send a strong delusion to people who have rejected the gospel, that they will believe the lie of the Antichrist, that you, a man or a woman, can become a god. That is the delusion. That's the lie that the devil, the Antichrist, will be putting out. That you can take his mark and become a god. That you can live forever. You can have eternal life here on earth. Live 1,000 years. Have your own paradise on earth. And rule and reign with the Antichrist. And be as God when you eat the fruit of taking his mark and worshiping him. That's what's coming. This is not natural. This is supernatural. The false prophet will call down fire from heaven on people. The whole world will wonder after the Antichrist, the beast. It'll say, who is like the beast? Who can make war with him? It's not a man. It's not Obama and all this other stuff. The whole world will wonder after the beast. Supernatural signs, lying signs, and wonders will be done. Wake up. Wake up before it's everlasting too late. The dim light that you have now that you don't know you have is about to go out. And sudden darkness will appear. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, Lord, on earth as it is in heaven. Lord, I ask you to give the tribulation saints their daily bread, for I know you will, Lord. Lord, I know you will not let them be taken in temptation, but you will deliver them from the evil one. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. In the name of Jesus Christ, Yeshua HaMashiach, blessed be the name of the Lord, God Most High, Creator of heaven and earth. May his word be sealed forever in the hearts of his people. God bless. I'll see you all on the other side. And I'm talking about the other side of the rapture, the other side of eternity, just over in the glory land. Just over in the glory land. We're going to have our time over in the glory land, over in Beulah land. That Beulah means married. We're no longer, God changed Israel from, you know, land of desolation to Beulah land. There's an old song, Beulah land. It means married. We're married to the Lord Jesus Christ. I take that back. We're about to be married. That's what it means over in Beulah land. Thank you, Lord. The Lord, see, the Holy Spirit of God will correct you. Even me in mid-sentence, he does it on a regular basis. I usually just don't say it. Beulah is married. We're about to get married. We're about to go through a marriage ceremony. Right now, we're betrothed unto the Lord. We're betrothed unto the Lord. And when the Lord comes, may he find you faithful and true. As I've said before, can you imagine if a bridegroom goes to get his bride? She's in there in the bed with another man. Do you think he's going to get her and take her to marry her? No. That's why the false church is staying here. All these old denominations with all their false doctrines and lying with other gods, they ain't going nowhere. Only those who are faithful and true, waiting on the bridegroom, ready to go in their white wedding gown, with their oil in their lamps, prayed up, packed up, looking up, ready to go up. Brothers and sisters, God bless you. As I said, pray up, pack up, look up, because we're going up. Praise be the living God, for his name is faithful and true. Love you guys. Bye.